NOCLAR stands for non-compliance with laws and regulations. It is a standard which covers all professional accountants, not just auditors, all professional accountants, including accountants in business. And it is a standard which looks at non-compliance in corporations, in companies, in organizations. So examples of non-compliance that an accountant may encounter are cases of tax frauds or securities frauds or non-compliance with environmental or health regulations. There's a whole range of possibilities, but of course NOCLAR is a standard that looks at very serious and harmful non-compliance. What the standard does is that it provides a guide to the judgment of the professional accountant, be it an auditor or a professional accountant in business, on how to respond to cases of non-compliance that he encounters during the performance of his or her duties. And a major point here is that it guides the judgment of the professional accountant in the direction of the public interest, because these are public interest situations. Now, the standard really breaks new ground because, you know, it raises the bar for the ethical conduct of all accountants. And at the same time, it is a balanced standard because it takes into account the role of the professional accountant, be it an auditor, a senior member of management in a corporation, or a mid-level person. So the standard graduates the requirements depending on the role, and this makes it a very balanced standard. The NOCLAR standard is a very robust standard, and it is robust because it establishes a pathway enabling accountants to disclose NOCLAR to a public authority. This can happen under some circumstances. The main circumstance is the following. If the accountant discovers a non-compliance, he must first inform management or those in charge with governance in the organization where the non-compliance takes place. If management or those charged with governance do not respond effectively to the non-compliance, then the accountant is enabled to disclose the matter to a public authority. The new standard, NOCLAR, changes the situation in several ways. Let me point out that an ethical responsibility not to turn a blind eye to non-compliance was always implied and mentioned in the code. However, there were no requirements, no guidance, no applications for this. Well, on how to respond, on what to do. So this standard now does precisely that. It gives, as I said, a pathway to the professional accountant to respond to non-compliance. The fundamental principle of confidentiality always got in the way of accountants who encountered cases of non-compliance, and it put them almost in a conflict situation. It confused their response. The standard enables accountants to set aside the principle of confidentiality when there is a strong public interest reason for it. The standard has three objectives that we're looking towards when it is implemented. The first is to enable professional accountants to comply with their ethical duty, their ethical responsibility to respond to non-compliance, and to respond in ways that serve the public interest. The second is to stimulate actions that either mitigate or better deter non-compliance altogether. This is a very important part of the objective, and it is something that will involve action from management and those in charge of governance in corporations where non-compliance may appear. The third objective is to stimulate increased reporting of NOCLAR to public authorities, to appropriate public authorities, I should say, whether this is required by law or regulation or not. So if you put all these three objectives together, you see that this has the potential to lead to a very different situation and a very different dynamic in the relationships between auditor and client. And it seems to me that it will contribute both to raise the reputation and the value society places on the auditor, and to motivate others who are members of management or those in charge of governance in corporations to be more sensitive and more responsive to non-compliance themselves. Besides adoption of the standard by accountants, I hope that the implementation of this standard will inspire other professions to step up as well and to raise their level of awareness and their ethical conduct vis-a-vis NOCLAR, and therefore that the accountants implementing this standard will act as an example for other professions. A second important matter here is, of course, that a lot depends also, and the Ethics Board expects, that governments will be very supportive to the implementation of this standard, because governments have a very important role, obviously, to play in these matters. First of all, they introduce and strengthen legislation addressing NOCLAR. And in particular, they can provide safe harbors to whistleblowers and to auditors and professional accountants who implement this standard. So governments can also do something else. Since government agencies will be receiving possible reports from the implementation of NOCLAR, they have the responsibility to take effective action on those reports. And that's no mean task. Finally, it seems to me that I should point out that the academic community has a very important responsibility and can also take a cue from this standard, because the academic community can play a role in researching, substantiating, and disseminating its conclusions about the impact of ethics in general and about the impact of this standard in particular on the function of reporting and financial transparency. Ultimately, there are many players that have to come in for a good implementation of this standard. The Ethics Board and its code cannot just do it alone. We need others to chip in and to contribute their own share in what? In fighting non-compliance, in trying to mitigate its negative effects, and in the end, in helping by mitigating these effects or by deterring non-compliance, in better operating markets, in better economies, and in higher well-being for everybody, for all of us.